Hello friends, welcome to Technic. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're going to compare two flagship level smartphones below the 25,000 price segment in India. We have the newly launched Realme X3 with the Snapdragon 855 plus octa-core processor, and we are going to compare it with the Redmi K20 Pro which just launched last year. So you might be thinking, why to compare the Redmi K20 Pro which just launched last year, almost a year old device, with a new device? But things to consider here is that both the devices come with last year's flagship processor, the 855. While we have 855 plus on the Realme X3, the K20 Pro has the Qualcomm's 855. Now both the devices have 8 gigs of RAM and offer good storage as well. Now both the devices have a good set of hardware being offered. So which of them is good to buy? That's what we are going to do in this video. So right now the Realme X3 base variant is priced at 24,999, while the Redmi K20 Pro is also priced 24,999. So that's the importance of this comparison. So before getting to the video, if this is your first time on this channel, do hit that subscribe button and also hit the bell icon to get notified of all the videos we publish. Now coming back to the comparison. So first let's have a look at the design and build quality. Now if you look at the back panel design of these two devices, you can see that both are made of glass finishing. The material quality on the Realme X3 looks matte finish, while it's a glossy finish on the Redmi K20 Pro. Both have pretty good build quality, solid offering, and even the material finishing looks really good. Now if you look at the design aspect, we feel the Redmi K20 Pro is a bit more compact to use thickness wise, the in-hand feel as well. It has a smaller display, so it's a well-built phone and it's kind of easier to use. But if you look at the Realme X3, it's a bit more bulky device. You can also see the thickness is also higher on the Realme X3, and overall the ease of use is definitely better on the Redmi K20 Pro. Now in terms of build quality, as I said before, both are premium looking smartphones, both have really good build quality. Now looking at the display, this is one important aspect to consider, because there's a vast difference in terms of the display aspect. Now the Realme X3 comes with an IPS LCD panel with 120Hz refresh rate. Now here we have the AMOLED display on the Redmi K20 Pro, but here you don't get the higher refresh rate, it's a standard refresh rate. But now it also supports HDR10 content. Now the important thing about the X3 display is that it's kind of very weak display, at least for the 25,000 price segment. This is kind of the brightness levels are also minimal, the display quality looks very weak. It should have been actually AMOLED display, but again it's more of cost cutting that has led to IPS LCD panel. Although it has 120Hz refresh rate, the display overall quality is nowhere close to the AMOLED display on the Redmi K20 Pro. Now both have Gorilla Glass protection, but here we would say the Redmi K20 Pro display is far better than the Realme X3. Now talking about the software. Now both the devices have Android 10. Initially the Redmi K20 Pro had the Android 9 with MIUI 11. Now MIUI 11 update came for the Redmi K20 Pro. Now we have the MIUI 12 update as well, and this has Android 10. Now here we have the Android 10 as well as Realme UI version 1.0. Now UI wise, we feel both look pretty good. Now both do not offer any sort of ads, and good experience overall. The MIUI 12 offers a plethora of new options. The UI feels refreshing. The same is the case with Realme's UI version 1.0. It's a refreshing UI. So we feel UI wise both are equally good. Now in terms of the performance, so both the devices have the Qualcomm Snapdragon 855 octa-core processor, while we have the 855 plus on the Realme X3. But in real-time usage, these don't actually make a huge difference. The plus variant is slightly overclocked variant, that's the only difference. So it doesn't make a huge difference though. Now gaming experience is again pretty good on both the phones. Now we have UFS 3.0 on the Realme X3. That definitely adds a bit more performance compared to the UFS 2.1 on the Redmi K20 Pro. So that's the performance side. So in terms of day-to-day experience, we did not see any sort of issues. Both are equally responsive, great overall experience, and both did a really good job in terms of app performance as well. We have done a detailed speed test, you can check out that video as well, so to find out how both these devices fared in terms of the app performance. Now, if you look at the fingerprint scanner, we have an in-display fingerprint scanner on this device, which is again a really good new tech, but then you get the side-mounted fingerprint scanner on the Realme X3. Now, the Redmi K20 Pro also has this pop-up selfie camera. Because of that reason, the face unlock is a bit slow compared to the Realme X3. But again, pop-up selfie camera is kind of a new tech, but then if you like or not, that's a personal choice. But then even with the pop-up selfie camera, the thickness of the Redmi K20 Pro feels much lesser than the Realme X3. Next is the camera. So both the devices have really good camera hardware. We have a 48 megapixel Sony IMX586 sensor, a 13 megapixel telephoto lens, and an 8 megapixel ultra wide angle camera. While we have a 64 megapixel Samsung sensor, and you also get an ultra wide angle camera, telephoto lens, and a macro sensor. So additional macro sensor is available on the Realme X3. Now, if you look at the camera samples, here, this is one area where we didn't see any major difference in these two cameras. Both look quite similar. In some places, the sharpness levels and colors were better on the Redmi K20 Pro, while in some areas, the Realme X3 did have an advantage. But overall, if you look at the camera aspect, we would say that neither of them are superior in terms of the camera experience. But the important thing to note is that the Redmi K20 Pro is almost a year old device. And even after 1 year of launch, the Realme X3 has not been able to get an improved camera than the Redmi K20 Pro. That's one important thing to note, because the Realme X3 is launched almost a year after, and even after a year, the camera performance is kind of weak for the price segment. So we have done a detailed camera review of the Realme X3. We found the camera to be very average. And the Redmi K20 Pro is not a really stellar camera by any means, but it's almost a year old camera. So that has to be taken into consideration. If you consider that, both devices did perform quite similar in terms of the camera experience. Now, both have selfie cameras, which are again quite okay. Now, we have a pop-up selfie camera, it's a 20 megapixel, while we have a punch hole dual selfie camera with ultra wide angle camera offered on the Realme X3. Now, next, moving on to the battery. So both the devices have really good battery capacity. We have a 4000 mAh capacity battery on the Redmi K20 Pro with the 27 watt fast charger, while we have a 4200 mAh with 30 watt fast charger. So both of them are quite good in terms of battery performance. In fact, both did really well in terms of battery performance. There is no major difference we felt. So in terms of battery experience, we feel it's more or less equal in terms of the overall experience. So now summing up, which one should you buy right now? Now, while the Realme X3 is a newly launched device, there are lots of things which are missing on the Realme X3. One is the 3.5mm audio jack, which is missing. While the Redmi K20 Pro has the headphone jack, that's an important thing, because even though we feel many brands are going without the 3.5mm audio jack, but still it's a really, really useful feature having a 3.5mm audio jack. That's one important thing Redmi K20 Pro has. The second thing is that the Realme X3 display performance feels kind of very average, while the Redmi K20 Pro has an AMOLED display. That's another advantage for the Redmi K20 Pro. While the Realme X3 has UFS 3.0 and 855 Plus chipset, that definitely has an advantage in terms of the app performance, but in terms of real-time experience, we did not see any major differences. Again, in terms of cameras as well, there was no major difference. So at 25999 pricing, you get an AMOLED display, headphone jack on the Redmi K20 Pro. So if you look at the overall experience, even after a year of launch, the Redmi K20 Pro looks like a slightly better deal overall out of these two devices, for the fact that AMOLED display, 3.5mm audio jack, and it also got the MIUI 12. So all these combined together, Redmi K20 Pro is still a really good value for money device. The Realme X3 is a kind of good offering, but we are kind of disappointed with how the camera performed, how the display experience is, and lack of 3.5mm audio jack is again another aspect. So that is a detailed comparison of the Redmi K20 Pro with the Realme X3. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit the subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next video. Have a great day.